Hello, John Bloodworth, Gentleman Crafter here with another Scan and Cut Saturday. This time a quick project using Craftex. Now, Craftex is a paper, but it's been mixed with latex so that it actually has more fabric-like or leather properties. It's 0.5mm thick, and when using the original unwashed formulation, it actually works very much like any other card when you're cutting it with a scan and cut machine. So, in essence, you can do this project whether you have a CM or SDX model of the machine. I'm going to show you how to assemble the design in Canvas Workspace, the installed version. That's the version that you download and install on your computer. And then I'll give you a few brief tips on how to work with the Craftex. So let's make a start in Canvas Workspace. These are the elements that I'm going to create, and there are specific things that I wanted to show you, particularly how to create rounded corners. Because we're working with quite a thick material, I don't necessarily want sharp corners or too many sharp corners, as this can put strain on the blade. So for the larger pieces, I'm using rounded corners. To do this, I've got to make a few changes, but first I'm going to hide the group that I've already created. Then I'm going to go to the Artboard tab on the right. I'm going to click Show Ruler and set the unit to inches. Turn on Snap to Grid and change the grid spacing to 1/4 inch. That's 0.25. So you can see we've got a lot more squares on screen right now. Now I'm going to show you how to create the rounded corners in a square, but then I'll show you how to extend that to be the lengthy design that we need for the cuff. So first up, I'm going to start by clicking once at the halfway point across my cuff, which is going to be 2 inches, and that will give me my starting point plus this elastic band thing that comes out. To get the rounded corners, we basically want to start the corner 1 grid spacing back, so we would single click. Then we drag out that elastic band so it's diagonally across that square. Click and hold the left mouse button down while we drag that out 1 square down. That will then give us our rounded corner and the next elastic band piece. And then we do the same for the next corner. So we single left click at the start of it, drag that elastic band out to where it's diagonal, then click, hold and drag, and then do the same for the next corner. Single click here, move your mouse to the next corner, click, hold and drag. And same again here. And then you would have that last piece that you would join up with your first point. So we now have our rounded corners, but how do we drag this out without distorting those corners? Well, with the object selected, click it again so that you enter the path editing tools. Drag a selection box around the bottom 4, and then I will zoom out. No, I won't. Yes, I will. And then use your down keyboard arrow to take it down to the size that you need. Now my wrist is, I've measured 8 inches, and I want to add maybe 1 inch on either end as well. So we're going to drag that down to 10 inches. Click anywhere on the mat to release. I'm going to apply a fill color to that so we can see what we're doing. Actually, I'm going to take that out because I want to see the grid underneath. So next up, I want to lock that in place, and then I will zoom in again, and I'm going to create a piece that's shorter or narrower than the original piece. So again, I'm starting at halfway, and this time I'm making those curves or curved corners at the next grid spacing. Now this time I can use my scroll wheel on the mouse to navigate to the bottom and then back up to the top. And then close that off. Okay, so we've got our two layers of cuff. Now we want to create the circles for the eyelets. So we're going to go into our shapes library, drag on a circle. Now here's a tip, place that top left point where you want roughly your circle to be. So I want it to be about half an inch down. And the reason for this is because I am going to zoom in and I want to change the size by typing the dimensions in the edit tab. And the circle will get shrunk up to that left corner. Now, I want to actually start working in millimeters here for these smaller circles, so I change the units over. That's either in the display menu up here or the artboard tab here. Now, for the little posts that I will screw my posts into, no, for the holes that I'm going to screw the posts into, I want them to be 4 millimeters. So I'll create one and then copy and paste for the second one. And I'm using that snap to grid to line those up 1/4 inch in from either edge. And they are 1/2 inch down. Are they 1/2 inch down? One, two, no, they're not. They're 3/4 inch down. I'm going to move them a bit further up. There we go. Now, for the ones at the bottom, for our adjustable straps, I'm going to scroll down. I'm going to drag in a circle again. And again, bring that top corner so it's in view. And these ones I want to be 5 millimeters. These are the ones that the posts are going to push through to hold the cuff in place. So again, I'm going to copy and paste. And then select both. Copy and paste again. And one more time so that I've got 6 in total. And they're spaced 1/2 inches apart. 1/2 inches? Is that even English? So that's what we've got so far. Now I want to duplicate these circles again. So I'm going to lock both of my bottom shapes, select all of those, Control V, and then I'll drag those over the top of the previous ones. Now, why would I want to do that? Well, I basically want to be able to punch these through all of the shapes. All of the shapes. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I should have grouped those, that would have made more sense. But I'm going to select, then in the edit tab, subtract. Back in the layers tab, select the remaining circles plus the bottom shape. And again in the edit tab, subtract. Now if I apply some color fill, you might see better what's going on. Drag that to the bottom. So you can see we've now got two layers of this. Excuse my phone. Both with all of these holes punched through so they line up. And I'm doing this to give the cuff a bit more strength and stability. Now, I want to create a... let me bring back the original one. I want to create a couple of slits to put these through and, of course, create these shapes here. So let me move that up. Now I'm going to change back to inches. 4 millimeters. Okay. So we want a line going across here. That's easy enough with the path tool. So I'm going to go up here, click, and we've still got this snap to grid on, so it will fall in place naturally. Double click at the end to set that in place, and then copy and paste to create your next one. And I'll move that in place. Now that's it for that one. So I can group those things together so that they will cut as one. There's no more to do on the base one, so that's fine as it is. So let's create these little doofries. Now they are 1 2 3/4 inch wide by 1 1/4 tall. So let's make this easy on ourselves and just grab a square. In the Edit tab, turn off aspect ratio lock. Set the width to 3/4 and the height to 1 1/4. Oops. That'll be 1 1/2, John, not 1 1/4. Then we want a circle to punch through it. So we're going to grab one of those. We're going to turn back on maintain aspect ratio and set the size to 1/2 inch. Move that over so that it goes over half of the rectangle. And the same for the other side. Select both and then subtract. We can then duplicate that and apply a color fill. Now, as I've said before, if I go a bit too fast in these videos on YouTube, don't forget that I have a full course over on Udemy. I will leave links in all of the relevant places so you can find that if you need a bit more personal tuition on using Canvas Workspace or the Scan and Cut. Now, everything is there ready to go. I'm actually just going to delete the original one and save this. And then basically, I will need to select everything and move it within the dashed red line, because I've been working to the edge of the design. But if I try and send it while things are outside that line, I will get an error message. So what I can do now is put two pieces of different colored Craftex on the mat and cut these at the same time. So I will transfer that over. And then I'll show you how I've set the machine up. So I've got the two strips of Craftex loaded onto my mat. I am using a fabric mat, as it's the only mat I've got at the moment that's got strong tack. You can use your standard mats, but I've got to re-tack mine, so they're not really up to the job right now. Okay, so basically, yes, you can use your standard mat with CM models of the machine. So I'm going to retrieve the design from Wi-Fi, which is where I sent it from. And I've got the design there, but just to make sure everything's positioned correctly, I'm going to scan a preview of the sheet with the bits on. So that's going through. Back it comes. And we can then see that everything is where it needs to be. So we click OK, choose cut, and you might want to do a test, and if you need to increase anything here, you can increase the cut pressure, cut speed, but I'm going to leave everything on auto for now because I'm using an SDX model. You will need to do a couple of test cuts with your CM models, but I'm just going to send that off to cut. Okay, the cutting has finished, so, okay, unload mat, then we can take it out, and start removing the craft decks. There we go, beautifully cut. Now, let's just try and do this with one hand. Now, when you've got it off the mat, there's a couple of things you're going to want to do. You're going to want to scrunch it up and keep re-scrunching and scrunching and scrunching and scrunching and battering it and shoving it into things and doing whatever you can to distress it. This is what's going to give us that leather look that we wanted from this material. Once you've finished scrunching, what you're going to do is get it in some water and soak it, and then dry it flat-ish, and then press it with the iron. You can also run it through your washing machine on a regular clothes cycle. Soap or unsoaped, doesn't matter. Maybe even chuck it through with a pair of jeans or some old towels. This colour won't run, but your colour from your jeans might run into it, which will give you a different look. And then, yes, like I say, dry flat and then give it a loose press with the iron, and I will come back and show you what result that gives you. Okay, so I've got my pieces here. They have been washed and dried, and you can see it's now much more flexible than the original sheet that it was, which was basically a sheet of card. It's now got the properties of sort of a leather or a textile. So I'm going to need some extra bits now. So I've got some fabric glue, got some clips, and I've got the hardware that's going to form the closure and the decoration. So the closures, we've got hitch fasteners. These packs come from Tim Holtz. However, you can buy them in bulk from obviously places like Amazon. So I'm going to use one of those, excuse me, and these were basically split rings, antique brass, and I got those to match the fastenings. So I'm going to need two of these little bad boys. Let me get a little tray to put them in and they won't run away. And I will need two of these little monkeys. One, two. There we go. So for the decoration, basically I want this split ring to sit in the middle here. And I want those to catch hold of it. So what I'm going to do with these is feed them through, fold them over, and then glue them in place. So let's get me some glue going on. Let's fold this over. And I'm going to clip this in place because it will take a few minutes to catch. I'll do the same with the other side. Oops, stay. One more clip, and then we can leave that to dry. So there we go. That's everything clipped in place. Now for these, I am intending to actually try and stitch down the outside edge. So I want to leave a space where there is no glue. So I'm going to apply the glue down the centre and obviously either side of these holes to make sure they stay in place. And I will need to leave some space to insert my fastenings. I don't want to put it too near the edge that it's going to catch the slots. Now this is the first time I've done it, so I can't say if this is too much or too little. I'm just basically winging it. Okay, so I need to make sure the holes are lined up. At both ends, and try and avoid getting my fingers covered in glue. I'm not too worried if the ones at this end aren't fully aligned. I'm more interested in making sure the two on their own are completely in place. Okay, now I need to make sure that I haven't stuck in there, so that's good. Yep, good. No glue, that's good. So I'm going to leave that to dry and then I will come back to it and carry on. In fact, actually, it should be okay for me to show you this bit now and then I'll show you the finished bit later when it's dry. So basically I'm taking one of these little screw head things, the posts, putting it up from underneath and then screwing one of these little knobby bits on the top. I'm going to do this finger tight for now, but it does have a flathead screw head, so you could potentially tighten it a bit more if you need to. Now obviously if I am sewing I would remove these, but for now I think that's good. And then basically, obviously, this will fold around and you'll put those knobby bits through the holes. It will be a bit tight on your first go, and that is fine. But as the fabric leather gives way, you should be able to get these through a bit better. There we go. See? It's in. Now, I will take it out for now. Because I've got to get this bit in here as well. So my goal here is to glue the end tabs inside those slots. Now, there isn't a huge amount of give for this. So I do need to be quite precise with the glue. Basically, this is what I will end up with, hopefully. Obviously, if you're doing this at home, you could make these a bit longer if you're concerned about that at all. Oops, there you go. So, let's see if I can manage this without completely mucking it up. Now that's way too much glue for the front. So what I'm going to do is actually take some of that and bring it around the back. then I'm going to try and open this up. Again, if you're stitching down the edges, you'll either need to make sure that you're using a very fine zipper foot to avoid this, or wait to put this in until after you've finished stitching. I can afford to put a bit more on the back. Okay, that's in. Might see if I can they reach? No, they can't. Let's see if I can find my other clips. Yes, I can. Put a couple at this end as well, just to hold that in place. Might be able to slide that one up. There we go. Okay, so we've got everything in place. It's all clipped. Let's leave that to dry and I will come back in a very short second. Just while that dries, a couple of quick things about Croftex. It's widely available in the UK and the US. I'm not 100% sure about other territories, but a quick Google for Croftex, C-R-F-T-E-X, should come up with a whole bunch of results that you can look at. The version that I'm using is unwashed, original unwashed. You'll see some for hand dyed pre-washed, you'll see some for pre-washed, but I highly recommend the unwashed version because that's the version that acts like cardstock when you're cutting it with your Scan and Cut. The other versions that are pre-washed will already have the fabric qualities that you've seen me share in the previous video, or earlier in the video, sorry. Now, Croftex has been around since about 2013. It was launched by C&T Publishing, and you can find a video on YouTube from them explaining the benefits of Croftex. I will link to it in the top right corner of this video. They do have some free projects on their website as well, ctpub.com. This mini suitcase is kind of cool. But yes, a bunch of free projects for you to use if you want to. And in the UK, the best source that I've found is Budley Crafts, so faux leather paper fabrics section of their website. And whilst they do have the pre-washed, much further down the page, you will be able to find the original unwashed versions. Price obviously depends on how much you are buying. And somewhere I did see a sampler pack, so you can buy a 5-color sampler pack 10 sheets for $17.99, and I could get a minimum of 2 cuffs from 1 sheet. So don't know whether that works out as good value, but as a non-animal alternative to leather, it's a good buy in my opinion. Anyway, back to the point. And so we went from this to this. That's my cuff completed. How fabulous. I would definitely make these tab bits a bit longer or move the cut lines closer here, as there's not too much space for those to go in. Perhaps even stitch across there as well. But this stuff is great. You can stamp on it as well with permanent dies. You probably want to do that, I don't know, before you wash it. If it's a permanent ink, it should stay on after a short cycle. But other than that, job done. Oh, and you can paint on this stuff too. Check out the website that I mentioned earlier and have yourself some fun. Okay, that's it for this one. Thanks for watching. Please remember to give the video a thumbs up and of course subscribe to the channel. In the meantime, thank you for watching.